The investigation carried out by the Indian Air Force confirmed what Shehnaz had never wanted to believe for four decades. Squadron leader Alam Siddiqui's B-57 bomber, stacked with explosives, had crashed in a field near Jamnagar in Gujarat. Nothing remained of either the plane or the pilot. There was no grave, no epitaph for this Pakistani pilot who died on the first day of the 65 war. Just a field in a small village in Jamnagar in Gujarat that became her shrine, a shrine of the fighter pilot she had loved and lost. There was no doubt in Shehnaz's mind that this was one pilgrimage she had to make, even if it meant that this journey, in all probability, would dash the very hopes that Shehnaz had clung to all these years. Here's where the story begins.
In my heart, I was still hoping that there would be a miracle. I knew, in all honesty, that I'm going to see the place where he had his last moments, and I'm sure in his last moments that he was thinking of me and my children.
Because we all knew Alam quite personally, and I thought that if ever we have to do this final visit, we should all be together.
Jamnagar has always stayed in my mind, so close to my heart, because that's where I thought I'll find him eventually. In a way, I did.
And find him here, she did. But not in the way she had hoped to. It was time for a final goodbye from a wife to a husband she had loved, unto death and much beyond. But when you have clung to memories so dearly, it's tough to let go.
Just now they heard an explosion sound here, and when they hit the flare again and making a second circuit over there, and that time it fallen down.
First people to reach the site were the villagers, localized.
Villagers,
and
yes.
They reached around 6 in the morning.
So there was no lives lost or anything because of the bomb. It just happened in the discharge of his duties.
Yes,
and
yes, yes.
Not because of his personal error of judgment.
Not.
Are you sure, no?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
I'm so happy to learn this that it wasn't his fault.
No, it wasn't at all.
It was other pre-war.
At a site where a Pakistani Air Force plane crashed with the pilot on board, an Indian Air Force officer comforting the widow of the supposed enemy. This is perhaps where borders cease to exist. Sometimes it doesn't matter which flag you wear on your chest, as long as you have a soldier's heart beating inside you.
I told my team not to treat them as any foreigners coming to us, to treat them in the same way as if we are looking for a wreckage of one of our own lost pilots.
We started our search on 14th Feb, it was Valentine's Day, and I was in the graveyard. Luckily, finally we were able to trace this crash site, and the result is positive. She has thanked us, but I think I should thank her for coming to this place and helping me in completing my mission.
I honestly don't know how to thank all of you.
This was all our...
the whole Indian Air Force for that matter.
मुझको अकेली कैसे.
Zalim was born in Lucknow. Being in the armed forces, he could not visit India at the time, but he said when he retires and when we travel around, he would like to take me to Taj Mahal. He was very possessive. He liked my singing very much, but
He said, when we are in a party situation, if I ask you for a second time, only then you should sing, because I know the crowd. And if I didn't want you to sing, I can say to you once. But when I say a second time, only then sing, otherwise don't.
The sadness still hasn't gone away, but at least we know that whatever was possible to do in this context, we have done.
The Indian Air Force helped a Pakistani Air Force officer's wife find her lost memories here in Indian soil. Three Pakistani citizens, one of them a soldier, will never forget this journey to India. It was time to salute the men who had made this reunion possible. Sometimes it just doesn't matter where you come from. A soldier's honor always stands tall. And who better to understand that than another soldier?
I have not saluted anyone in a long time. but you, my wholehearted and full honor at my command, I salute you.
Ye Air Force wallahs, it doesn't matter which uniform you wear, we are all the same.
A wife of a Pakistani soldier paying homage not to just Indian soldiers, but to their families as well, who shared the same pain as hers, even though the borders separated them.
We are the same people. Doesn't matter if we live on this side of the border or that side of the border, but we come from the same region, same culture. I hope we can stay always like that.
I hope so.
Nobody else will ever suffer.
Unfortunately, on this side of the border as well, several have suffered. We'll get you their stories when we come back from this break. As we go, the men who etched their names in history forever.